Hello, good evening everyone, and a hearty welcome to all the viewers of English Poetry on Neelam Saxena Chandra's Facebook page live. This is an English Poetry Meet, and at the outset, I would like to invite one by one our very dynamic and talented poets for today. So we begin with our special guest, Mr. Shanti Bhushan Roy, who is a celebrated personality, an eminent filmmaker, cinematographer, and an educator who has worked extensively in diverse range of media, from film to television, documentaries, web and digital camera. He is an alumnus of the prestigious Film and Television Institute of India, Pune. Wow. He has worked with well-known Indian actors and Bollywood celebrities like Aamir Khan, Nana Patekar, Anil Kapoor, Mahi Gill, Papon, Guru Radhawa, etc., etc., and also with international and national television channels like BBC, Discovery, NHK, NGC, Star, Sony, etc. He has several feature films, non-fiction features, and several programs, TV commercials, and music videos to his credit. His film credits include the award-winning, Oscar-acclaimed Ballad of Rustam, Wedding Anniversary, Taramira, Bhagte Raho, Rubaru Roshni, Asma, etc., and the milestone TV programs like Satyamev Jayate with Aamir Khan, along with many other celebrities. He has worked with them. He also has his own website, www.shantibhushanroy.com. So he has been a juror and a panelist, an avid reader. He is and also a passionate poet. And besides that, he teaches and mentors students at various government and private institutions. So welcome, Shanti Bhushan Roy ji, to our show. It's a pleasure and an honor to have you in our midst.
Lovely, so lovely.
Welcome.
We welcome you, sir.
We have such an eminent personality with us.
Welcome,
so welcome.
Sir.
Okay. Next, we move on to Miss Purnima Raut, who is a very accomplished poet. Where is Purnima Rao ji? I can't see her.
I think she has left the studio. Yeah. So
okay.
when she comes, you know, I'll add her to the stream.
Okay. Yeah. So in the meantime, I will introduce her to our viewers. Mrs. Purnima Rao is a very accomplished poet. She is a teacher by profession and she teaches physics at plus two level. She recently retired after 37 years of service from the Christ Church Boys Senior Secondary School, Jabalpur. She continues to coach and help students with her online teaching. Writing is a passion she has developed over the past few years. She mostly pens poems and prose in English and sometimes also in Kannada. We welcome you, Purnima ji. And moving on, let me introduce our next participating poet, Miss Pooja Nangia, who is an educationist, a podcaster, and now a published author of a poetry book called Akanksha. She is an this is her book. She is just holding it on. So this is very, very nice, Pooja. Congratulations for this book. And she is an edutech professional, and she believes all children are capable in their own ways. She is an empath and a believer in her ideology, and likes to express her reflections of life through her poems. She keeps her passions alive by learning new things and constantly evolving. Her podcasts on poetry and parenting can be heard on various platforms like Hubhopper, Spotify, and Gaana One. So welcome, Pooja. And now,
welcome, Pooja.
We also have with us Ms. Shweta Khanna, who is born and brought up in the city of Nawabs, Lucknow. Shweta presently presently resides in Bengaluru, where she works for an edutech company. She had a poetic bent of mind from an early age. She writes stories, articles, and poems, both in English and Hindi, poetry being her forte. She is an educationist by profession and a writer by passion. She has published a book, Being a Woman, a compilation of her poems, and she has also contributed to a few anthologies. Her hobbies include painting and craft work. Well, that's great. She's an avid learner who firmly believes that each day is a blessing, which should be lived to the fullest. Wow, what a philosophy, Pushweta.
Thank you, Seema-ji.
Yeah. And now I would like to invite our very charming and acclaimed poet, the admin of our show today, who is Dr. Poornima Kulkarni. A very warm welcome, dear Poornima. Poornima is a literature and English language trainer, motivational speaker, research-oriented writer, author, biographer, and a profound poetess. She has been a research scholar at Residence, EFLU and OUCIP, Hyderabad. She has published her research papers in national and international journals. She has authored a chapter to a book on the theater of Mahesh Dattani. She has published her anthology of 51 poems, Assorted Plumerias, dedicated to Dr. Nitish Bhardwaj. Her magnum opus, Permutations and Combinations of Love, is an international anthology for which she has collaborated with 7 celebrated poets across the globe. Her latest book, Autographs from Heaven, is a celebration of 60 flowers. So these were the 5 poets, and now over to you, dear Poornima. Yeah, please carry on, Poornima.
Thank you so much, Seema-ji. So many viewers have joined us, and you know, what a moment it is. It gives me tremendous pleasure to introduce Seema-ji. Seema-ji, I read her, you know, bio, but I thought, you know, I know her for quite some time now. We did a poetry meet together, so I thought yes. I will introduce her spontaneously. You know, it is said that other eminent people abide our questions, but Seema-ji is not subject to our doubts and questions. She remains as elusive as the highest pinnacle of knowledge, and her grandeur is known to scholars and critics. Oh. She's like the loftiest hill, revealing a grand to the stars and to the sunbeams, and this majesty of lofty hills, its sublime heights are invisible to us, for we can see only the cloudy border of its base and not the sublime heights. So to sound the depth of this lady is a fruitless attempt. It baffles all analysis and understanding. Seema-ji, she is a professor from Jalandhar University, who's compiled multiple anthologies, and she's also anthologizing a magnum opus. She's bringing all the, you know, women poets together through a project. Seema-ji, would you like to, you know, tell the viewers about it before we begin?
Yeah, I would love to do that, Poornima. Thank you for this opportunity and for asking me to do that. In fact, I am these days working on a project called, I'm compiling an anthology of women poets who are writing in English, and in Indian women poets who are writing in English in the 21st century. That is currently at present who are writing. So it's a huge project, and I have received an overwhelming response for it. And I think that when it really comes near conclusion, maybe about 80 to 100 poets might be a part of it, which I think will be something.
Great endeavor. You know? Great endeavor.
Thank you.
Hats off, Seema-ji. Okay, so big hello to the viewers here. We love you to the moon and back. And now we begin with our monsoon special in a poetry show. Seema-ji, should we start?
Yeah. Please, let me take on. So, dear friends, we are ready now to start the poetry reading round. And let me tell our viewers, as Poornima has already mentioned, that the theme selected for the first round of poems today is monsoon. We are in the midst of the monsoon season, enjoying its varied hues. So let's see how our poets respond to the season's moods and melodies. So again, we begin with Shanti Bhushan ji. Shanti ji, I invite you to present your first poem on the theme of monsoon, in which he is talking about how drops of water trickle down and desires melt and break all shackles. So over to you, Shanti ji. Please present your first poem.
Great. Looking forward.
Thank you, Seema-ji, Dr. Poornima, and my fellow artists and poets, Poornima Rao, Pooja Nangia, Shweta Khanna. It's really an honor to be in this august company. and being given this honor to present my heart scribble, which I call as poem. I don't know whether they are poem, but they are my. They have come from heart, and I just write it free flow. Yeah.
Yes.
So we are in monsoon, and also it's we are all in a pandemic situation as well. We are battling. We are battling in our minds and hearts and physicality. So we are living in multiple worlds. It's a small try. The title of the poem is called "It's Monsoon." It starts. Sun shines softly, as if it's on my loft. The toy car goes vroom. I'm stuck in my room. Thunder and lightning scare me. For my cat, it's frightening. My dog's endless barks as if it has seen sharks. I love to sit by my window. I love to sit by my window, soaking in the play of light and shadow, having my cup of tea, forgetting where I have left my keys. Everyone is in their nest. Birds, monkeys, squirrels. The trees sway to the gentle wind. Leaves fall and touch the earth. Drops of water trickle down. Desires melt and break all shackles. Divine oneness of souls, dancing of hearts, engulf the sheets. My heart soars as our eyes meet. Poets paint pink. Colors, nature, and emotions have infinite link to our love and our togetherness. The storm within has transformed. Let it all flow. Just keep your glow. But let's have marshmallows. Oh, my beloved. It's like, oh, my beloved, hold me close and sing. I could go weak on my knees, sparkling and shining behind cloud doors. I miss the moon. Is it monsoon? Yes, it is monsoon.
Oh my God, so beautiful.
So beautiful.
Lovely.
So beautiful.
Lovely. Very vibrant.
Well,
and so many figures of speech, you know, I like the personification. So beautiful.
And I think the way he has rendered it is equally beautiful, along with the poem being beautiful. So well, after listening to the wonderful and very evocative poem by Shantiji, I now invite Purnima Raoji to please share her poem on monsoon with us. She has tried to portray the beauties of the rainy season in her poem. So Purnima ji, please go ahead.
Thank you, Seema ji. And thank you, Purnima, and also Neelam Saxena ji for giving us this wonderful opportunity.
True. Yes.
And my namaskar to all my viewers. With a little bit internet problem, I was out of view for a few seconds. Monsoon is a much awaited season after that scorchy summer, especially in the northern part of India.
I think there is some problem with her audio.
She has bandwidth issues. Yeah.
Okay. So let's wait for a moment whether she's able to get back with us.
In the meanwhile, Seema ji, would you like to tell us what our viewers have to say?
Yes, I think, Purnima, if you can see the comments, I would request you to please read some of the comments.
Actually, they are not
displaying on my screen.
Okay.
She's back. So, over again.
Oh, she's
I'll
back.
Just start it over
she's
again.
Back. That's
no
good.
Problem. I'm just starting it over again. My poem is Monsoon Delights. A powdery drizzle welcomed me. And onto my terrace I tiptoed. As the soft sun rays played through, the wonder of nature I eyed. Stepping out of a bridal bath. She had dressed in a garb of golden green, a thousand sequins packed on a gown. Raindrops on the leaves did seem. The hibiscus harp beckoned me. Red pink blooms and mauve together. Their stem cuttings too had sprung to life, bursting of microgreen sprouts all over. With the aroma of life in the monsoon air.
There is again some connectivity issue, I think. Yes. So in the meantime, Purnima, if you can see the comments of the viewers, I would request you to take some comments.
All right. Okay, Ritvika okay. finds, you know, your rendition beautiful. And Nivedita ji has joined us. Pramod Saxena says, welcoming participant poets on Neelam ji's page. There is someone called BFSPL, Shanti Bhushan Roy Poetry is very heart touching. You've got a compliment here, Shanti Bhushan ji. Nivedita says, lovely environment with beautiful souls here. Yeah. So we have some people are literally heaping encomiums on you. Pramod Saxena, Pramod Saxena, welcome. Okay, there's someone called Usha Swaminathan, beautiful Purnima Rao.
Thank you so much.
Vijay Kumar says it's called monsoon. I think this is in reply to Shanti ji's poem. It's called monsoon. Lovely poem. Okay, so some wonderful. Sunny says hello. Hello, Sunny. How are you? Okay, so Purnima ji, are you back? Are you back with a good bandwidth so that we are able to hear you clearly?
Shall I repeat it once more?
Yes, yes, please.
If you permit me.
Monsoon connection is still unstable.
It's showing.
The video is fluctuating.
Okay, that's been happening. I don't know, from morning this has been, although we complain.
Never mind. Please go ahead.
A powdery drizzle welcomed me and onto my terrace. I tiptoed as the soft sun rays played through the wonder of nature. I silently eyed, stepping out of a bridal bath. She had dressed in a garb of golden green, a thousand sequins tacked on a gown. Raindrops on her leaves did seem. The hibiscus hub beckoned me. Red pink blooms and mauve together. Their stem cuttings too had sprung to life, boasting of microgreen sprouts all over, with the aroma of life in the monsoon air. Balsams popped up here, there, everywhere. Their slender stems were gathering strength for the colorful bunches they need to bear. As I look down on the ground below, the short-lived seasonals were in a real mood, carefree and enjoying the monsoon bash. Past or future was not their time to brood. Thank you.
Lovely poem, Purnima ji. Lovely poem.
Thank you. Thank
Very
you.
Very nice.
Thank you all. Yeah.
So, after this beautiful poem by
Purnima,
thank you. Thank you, Shanti Bhushan.
Very nice. Very absorbing. Yeah.
Very nice. So, let's now hear Pooja Nangia's poem on monsoon, which is an attempt to capture the tune of nature. Over to you, Pooja Nangia. Please go ahead with your first poem.
Thank you. I'll begin by saying thanks to the host and namaste to all the viewers. So my poem is about these all the senses that become so functional in the monsoon during the monsoon season. The clouds are dark, the drizzle is slow, the thunder afar, trees whistle, leaves fall, flowers at their bloom, greens awash, and I hear the tunes of nature. I hear the tunes of nature. Mesmerizing chirps, petrichor in my breath as I close my eyes. All I see is the bliss of the present, the gift of nature, the gift of nature. The newness of the old, the blues are there, yet gone. So we see this blue sky, but the Monday blues are still gone. The greens wave their hands to embrace me as I open my arms, my feet covered in mud. The grounds are slippery, yet I know they will hold me tight as I smile with all my might, gleefully to the sights of nature, gleefully to the sights of nature. Thank you.
Very
How
nice.
How sweet.
Very sweet. Very, very nice. Captivating.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. We really enjoyed it, Pooja.
Yeah.
So thank after this so captivating poem by Pooja, I would request Shweta Khanna to present her poem on monsoon. That poem is titled Awaiting. And the poem tries to capture the changing moods of nature in this rainy season. Shweta, please go ahead.
Yes. Thank you, Seemaji. And a big namaste to one and all. Basically, I'm really lucky to share this platform with such eminent poets. And a big thanks to Neelamji for providing us this wonderful platform. So without taking much time, I would begin with my poem. Awaiting, that's the title of my poem. So it goes on. The parched soil, full of hope, craved longingly for some solace. After all the adversities of the scorching summer, was awaiting the monsoon, still with grace. The little drops of water to pacify the soul would be there. It's just a matter of few days. But suddenly, the light breeze turned intense, and in no time, there was a change in the scene. The dark clouds shadowed the sky, barricading the sun's eternal regime. Behold, the signs of the awaited arrival appeared like fulfillment of a cherished dream. The first drop of water touched the soil, filling it with the prodigious glee. It appeared like the return of the long lost love, a divine adoration that all could see. The drops turned into the welcome shower, bringing an end to the air of melancholy, bringing an end to the air of melancholy. Thank you.
Wow. The last line especially is so full of hope. Thank bringing so an much. Air of melancholy to an end.
I didn't want it to end, Shweta.
Yeah, really, really.
Thank you so much. Thank you so
we
much.
We could go on and on listening to you. Thank you, Shweta.
That was, and the rendition also was filled with emotion.
Filled with emotion. Yes.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so Purnima, here I would like you to take up some comments.
Some viewers' responses. Okay, I need to give up my vanity and wear my spectacles for that. Wow, that's great, Shweta. Amit Khanna says, wow, that's great, Shweta. Kanhaiya Lal says, nice. Jayashree says, beautiful poems, Pooja and Shweta. Raj Kamal says, how are you, Pooja ma'am? So please reply. Pooja ma'am, aapka koi fan aa gaya hai yahan par, aapse pooch raha hai. How are you, Pooja ma'am? And Shreya Khanna says, very nice. And there's someone called Nightingale. Oh my God. Now I don't want to read my poem because there's Nightingale here. Nightingale, very nice, Shweta. Fulfilled the weight, the joy. Oh, she specifically mentioned a few words. which were emphasized here. And on the whole, everyone is liking the show. They're finding it beautiful and awesome, and all sorts of adjectives are pouring in here. Rendition was indeed catering to the senses. Oh my God. Wow. See, look at the compliments.
Thank you so much.
Yes, compliments.
Yeah.
So I'm really so glad that our viewers are liking the whole show. And now I would request you, Purnima, to please present your first poem, Raindrops, Capturing the Magic Wrought by the Tiny Drops of Rain. So please go ahead, Purnima, with your first poem.
Thank you so much, Seemaji. Let me tell you that you've been comparing and anchoring the show really well. Oh. Hello, dear viewers. This is Purnima, your poet. Raindrops. My poem is called Raindrops. I see raindrops falling on my slender fingers. Raindrops in my bewitchingly beautiful hazel eyes. Raindrops enlivening my indomitable spirit. Raindrops cajoling me to utter a sigh. I hear raindrops that clatter on the rooftops. Raindrops that sound like scattered string of pearls and peridots. Raindrops that make me pine and swoon. Jaltarang raindrops that are sweetly played in tune. I feel the raindrops that cover the valleys with sheets of cloud. Raindrops that make me laugh out loud. Raindrops that take me into a pleasant reverie. Raindrops that fall on the mirrors created by the Lake Isle of Innisfree. Lake Isle of Innisfree is a place in Ireland. I can smell the raindrops that moisten my blooms. Raindrops that spread aroma in my living room. Raindrops that perfume my deep sleep. Raindrops that kiss the leaves of trees. I need a draft of raindrops drizzling down to the ground. Raindrops that quench the thirst of the earth. Raindrops that make the environment damper. Raindrops that mix with pristine air and flood my lungs and pamper. I dream of the raindrops that fall on mountain mists. Raindrops that do not fall on my bare palms and wrists. Raindrops that I cannot catch at bedtime. Raindrops that flutter and dance and slightly touch my wind chimes. Raindrops are small, weightless forms, yet striking with astonishing force. Little drops carry so much meaning. Be it tears that trickle down our cheeks or raindrops that enter life's minute pores. Raindrops build our reality for us to be whoever we want in actuality. It's all those minute details that bring us closer. At the core of our souls lies this factuality. Thank you so much.
Beautiful poem. Beautiful.
Fabulous.
Fantastic.
Thank you so much.
It's really, really wonderful.
Purnima, whenever I'll be looking at the raindrops, I'll be remembering you now.
Thank you so much.
You know, I just realized there's so much that can be absorbed, so much that can be learned from a tiny raindrop. Because I think, you know, tiny things are quite impactful and they do matter. Okay. When we talk about eye for detail or, you know, minutest things, even in our, you know, day-to-day life, you know, those raindrops do matter. So I just wanted to, you know, end my poem on a didactic note, which would give some message to our viewers.
Yeah. In fact, I am a firm believer, Purnima and everyone, that it is the tiny things and the little things in life that are the most important.
True. Absolutely. I think Purnima ji is waiting in the waiting room while I was presenting. I will just add her to the stream.
Please try to add her,
Okay.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. I was listening to the latter part of your poem. Very, very nice.
Very nice poem. Okay.
Thanks for being deeply overwhelmed.
The way you say it, and also Shweta, your rendering was amazing.
Thank
Please,
you. Thank you.
Yeah, I would like to request after Dr. Punima's poem, let's see some viewers' comment as well.
Yeah. Please, Punima, I request you.
They are not visible. Yeah. So then I have to wear my spectacles for that.
Yeah.
Isn't that funny? Because, you know, the thing is...
No, it is not. I'm wearing the spectacles.
You are wearing spectacles. Oh, yes. Yeah. So, see, someone is matching. Okay, Smita Khanna, great performance. Okay, Smita, was that for me? Thank you so much. Prachi Vijay says, very well presented. Maya Khandelwal, a tiny raindrop is pregnant with hope, love, and blessing. Maya, your views are amazing. And next time, I must say, you must, join our presentation. Lovely lines. Juma says, Seema, your voice is so calming. Seema, better start a meditation camp or something because your voice is quite calming and soothing. Okay, Vidya Srivastav says, hello, Purnima. Hello, Vidya. Jayashree says, raindrops explained in so many ways. Brilliant, amazing, rendering Purnima so lively. This is narcissism alert. Let me have some other comments. Okay, Sunil Tiwari says, great. Okay, so I guess, some more comments will arrive in the second round. Vidya says, raindrop was great. Okay, thank you so much, dear viewers, for appreciating us and loving the show. And your comments do mean a lot. Thank you so much.
Yeah, they're very inspiring for all of us.
Yes.
And
very encouraging and motivating.
So after this beautiful rendition by Purnima Kulkarni, now I would like to present my poem that is titled Monsoon. So here it goes. As the monsoon showers descend from the gray skies, from the parched soil, a sweet fragrance doth arise. The drip drip of raindrops sliding down the windowsills wraps my mind in its enchanting rhythm. The wetness in the air evokes a numbing pain, a longing to be drenched in your love's rain. The aroma of hot pakoras and ginger tea tingle the taste buds, triggering sweet memories. Sprinkle of love over the hardened earth quenches its enormous pangs of thirst. Monsoon showers bring such a cooling delight from the hot, dusty months, such a welcome respite. Newly bathed are rooftops and window eaves, trees, grassy lawns, and the tender leaves. The wild creepers at an alarming pace grow. Everywhere, all around, is a lush green glow. The lilting songs in the air with the swings on the trees and the merry damsels dancing add to festivities. The cooing of cuckoos and the music galore, Mother Nature seems to give more and more. The scanty rivers overflow with waters aplenty, gurgling, guffawing, unleashing their bounties. But as everything sweet has a flip side to it, the monsoon season also is not without its blues. At times it wreaks havoc upon human settlements, inundating lands, animals, people, hutments. Cloudbursts, landslides, thunderstorms, floods. Nature's vengeance on man gone berserk. Come, let's beware of nature's deadly wrath and celebrate its magnanimity with a welcoming heart. So this was my poem, Monsoon.
Beautiful, Seema ji, beautiful. And let me tell the viewers, I want to say something. Seema ji just lost her, brother. He merged with the elements and she was not very sure whether she would, participate in the show. But I'm so proud of this woman. She wrote this poem just a few days back, and she said, I don't know, you know, whether it's up to the mark. I don't know. I'm not very happy with it because, you know, I was not in the right frame of mind. But I think she's written such a deeply poignant poem. And I think, you know, she deserves a big round of applause for this. It's not easy to write a poem on monsoon, especially after losing a, you know, dear one. So, Seema, beautiful poem, beautiful.
Thank you.
Beautiful it is. Yeah.
I would like to dedicate it to my dear brother.
Lovely poem.
Yes.
Lovely
poem. Yes. Yes.
His soul rests in peace. And
yes.
Okay. So after this first round of such beautiful poems, I'm sure our viewers must be enjoying all the poems. Let's now move on to the second round. So for the second round, the next poem, I invite Shanti Bhushan ji to recite his poem titled Of Myself. Over to you, Shanti ji.
Before, thank you, Seema ji, and thank you everyone for this beautiful round. And I got to hear some amazing poetry from my fellow poets. And Dr. Punima, can I make a request after Simaji's beautiful poem, would you like to take some
Let's see what the comments are. Okay, so Pragya is here. Pragya says, delightful poem, Simaji, everything sweet has a flip side to it. Beautiful. Anup Pandey ji is a great friend of ours. He says, Simaji, salam to your bravery. He appreciates your spirit. Maya Khandelwal says, OMG, that's heart-rending, Simaji. Nature is magnanimous. Wow. Yeah, Maya Khandelwal, some, you know, thank beautiful you, comments. Anup Pandey ji says, welcome, Shanti Bhushan ji. Let me tell you, Shanti Bhushan ji, Anup Pandey ji is a quite a prolific writer and a spontaneous poet. And, you know, he's happy to have you here. Juma Simaji said, more strength and love. Pragya again says, it gives me goosebumps learning about your loss, Seema ji. Sunil Tiwari says, so beautiful. I'm sure, you know, Seema ji is getting goosebumps too and loving all the comments.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so let us begin the second round, and we're looking forward to hearing Shanti Bhushan ji again.
Okay. Thank you so much. After this beautiful rendition of Monsoon, I'm sorry, I'll get a little serious about, I'm presenting a bit little serious, on serious note. The recent development, because as artists and poets, and also being educator, we all are educator in some way or other. Our heart definitely reaches out to our fellow human beings. And what happens around the world affects us as well.
True.
The recent development in Afghanistan, I'm not talking about the politics of it. In any of the conflict, who suffers the most are the fellow human beings, and particularly women and children. It's not that men don't suffer, but women and children and elderly, they suffer the most. And we saw the entire, it's like another pandemic which has been hit, and it is the kind of wave which has hit. And this is my small, I was overwhelmed as an artist, as a poet, as a human being. I was overwhelmed by the sight which I was seeing on the television. And also the way the entire, the freedom of expression, which is our innate nature as a human being. A nature, only one thing which I feel gives us, makes us living being is the freedom to express. Every living being expresses themselves in some way or other, and we all want to express. That's where artists are the conscious keepers of the civilization, and they have taken civilization further. Any society which mauls or stops creativity does not remain a livable society. And what was happening in Afghanistan, the women artists in particular were being shunted out, so not going anywhere. So it's, I'm just taking a bit of time because I'm just collecting myself. because it does get a little tough. The title of the poem is I Will Always Sing. I won't let go. I won't let go of myself. I won't let go of myself, music of my soul, it's precious. I won't give up. I won't give up my freedom to sing, to love, to be human. I won't. Darkness, threat, violence, gun, beard, turban have no solace. Opium tonic makes mine tick. How can they ban music? Opium tonic makes my mind tick. How can they stop music? They forget to be human. How can they kill anyone? They can't take my soul, my goal, my dream, as I scream in pain, but without gain. They can't take my soul, my goal, my dream, as I scream in pain, without gain. I won't give up. I won't give up my music. They have no logic. It's tragic. I won't give up my music. They have no logic. It's tragic. My soul will long for freedom. My soul will long for freedom. I will always be in the ring. My soul will long for freedom. I will always be in the ring. I will always sing. I will always sing. Thank you.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Oh my God.
It is such a touching poem, Shantiji. I'm speechless.
Very touching.
Unable to say anything. Very touching. And at the same time, what an appropriate representation of the horrible reality that is unfolding around us.
Yeah.
So very well captured and very heart touching.
And it's really the helplessness that is more overwhelming. We have to see it and can't do anything about it.
So we can only pray that peace prevails everywhere and human dignity is maintained.
Thank you so much.
After this moving poem by Shanti Bhushan ji, I would request Purnima to take some viewers' comments.
Sure.
I'm sure our viewers also must have responded to this beautiful
Tibari,
poem.
Sunil Tibari ji says, yes, you are great, Shanti Bhushan ji. Pooja Kapoor says, very nice. Amit Khanna says, quite touching. Great, Shanti ji. Pragya says, poignant expression, Shanti ji. Very well rendered.
Very well, yeah.
And Vijay Kumar says, I have read some of Shanti ji's poems. Oh, wow. I'm glad to hear Vijay Kumar. This is the first time I'm hearing the words from his mouth. I Will Always Sing is simply marvelous with a capital M. Marvelous with a capital M, Shanti ji. Beautiful, beautiful comments there. Lovely. And most importantly, he was totally in the situation, you know, being a filmmaker, being a poet, he knows how to, you know, combine reason, emotion, and he emoted it so perfectly.
Yeah.
Beautiful, Shanti ji.
I think we were all spellbound.
I think Vijay Kumar.
Spellbinding, very spellbinding. Yeah.
Mr. Vijay Kumar, I would like to, through this channel, I would like to invite him because he is an accomplished poet himself and he's a learned man.
Okay.
He's a learned, very, very learned man from Imphal. And his kindness.
Manipur.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. And he's a very learned, learned person and he's a poet himself. He's a writer and commentator. And I really admire his appreciation, if it has come from him, it matters a lot.
That means a lot.
That means a lot. Because he's a distinguished persona himself. So, when a compliment comes from such an accomplished person, it feels great.
Yeah. It's really great. So,
thank you so much.
Moving on. Moving on, I now invite Purnima ji to present her next poem, Don't You Dare. And if I'm not wrong, I think this is also focusing upon the situation in Afghanistan.
Yes, Seema ji. Yeah. It has really affected me. Of course, there are political and geographical ramifications of whatever has happened there. But
I think as poets, we focus on the human aspect of it.
Yes, exactly. And more so on the plight of the women and children.
Yes.
That's what really,
heart-rending. Purnima's connection, I think, is playing truant again.
Whenever she reads a poem, the connection goes away.
Otherwise, it's fine.
Just pray that the connection is there. Just pray for me. Okay? I'm going to
Pray. Please go.
The connection is there and start.
Soul connected.
Please do.
The title of my poem is Don't You Dare. You come in droves, riding in open cars and jeeps, guns slung over your shoulder, with your fingers on the trigger. Some young, some not. Your heads are covered. Faces, too, are partially hidden, only revealing those scary eyes. Your eyes are like windows to your brainwashed minds, sowed with seeds of poisonous weeds. Victims of your unbridled lust, women and children run skelter. As their world comes crumbling down, they still hope for a miracle shelter.
The connection is again weak, I believe, and it's not, we can't hear her.
Yes, so, she's lost her connection. I'll just continue.
Triumphant are you monsters in her disrobed distress?
She was reading something so significant.
Yes.
Let's wait.
I think the second poem was supposed to be a short, so I think, she must not have written a very long poem. I think, she gets back.
She's back.
May I continue, please?
Yes, sure.
Victims of your unbridled lust, women and children run shelter. As the world comes crumbling down, still they hope for a miracle shelter. Triumphant are you monsters in a disrobed distress? Humanity touching an abysmal low, no pardon shall follow. But beware, she's your creator. Do not rejoice in your victory parade. If she creates, she can destroy too. Her helplessness, don't you dare.
Wow, wonderful. What a wonderful message she has tried to give. Message.
Very nice.
Very poetic.
Thank you.
It was Shelley. It was Shelley who said, our sweetest songs are those that tell of saddest thoughts.
The saddest thoughts.
And, when I heard your poem, it has excruciating pain. It has agony, anguish. And yes, it is And now I think, you know, our second theme should have been Afghanistan. All of us would have written something.
I also think so. But I'm so glad,
you know, Shanti Bhushan ji and Purnima ji thought about them. And it was very thoughtful of them to have chosen this topic. So hats off.
Yeah. It was very important to highlight this.
Yes.
The pain and the misery of the people. Yeah.
Yes.
So. Well, after this, after both these beautiful poems on a similar situation, I would now like to invite Pooja Nangia for her next poem titled Five Elements. Over to you, Pooja.
Can we take some comments?
Comments. All right.
Yeah.
Okay, so Raj Kamal ji says, very beautiful. Jayashree says, if she can create, she can destroy too. Lovely. She's like this antithesis. Usha Swaminathan says, powerful poem. Jayashree says, what a strong message, Purnima. Proud of you. Raj Kamal says, it has touched my heart. Prachi Vijay says, words are showing the misery in Afghanistan. Yes, very true, Prachi. And Sunil Tiwari says, it's a wonderful poem. So I'm glad that the viewers are equally involved.
The poems
are riveting, but our, you know, viewers are, you know, quite absorbed in the renditions. So we extend our heartfelt gratitude to you, dear viewers. Keep going. And this means a lot to all of us.
Yeah. So over to you, Pooja, now. Please go ahead.
So my poem is called Hope, Not Hunger. This is from the words of the migrant laborers that we saw swarming, you know, during the first round of pandemic. What is it that they would have said? So it is right from the, you know, mouth of the laborer himself. It says, hope, not hunger, is what I wanted. As my work got leaner and I lay exhausted with the thought of future that may not be so bright. The money became scarce and the support was sparse. As I see my hungry kids with swollen eyes, this is what I thought. This is what I thought. The camps were few. The help was lean. Would I be better in my nest? I flew the miles from. How would I go back? With no means, the only choice was to surrender to being prone to the disease or to the hunger. Was it a choice at all? Was it a choice at all? As I walked the miles in the hope, barefoot in the sultry sun, and I tell myself, hope is all I want. Hope is all I want. Thank you.
Wow.
Very nice.
Very nice. Very nice. Okay. So moving on. Yeah. I now invite Shweta Khanna to present her poems. I think Five Elements is Shweta's poem. So I invite her to present her poem now.
Thank you, Seemaji. So in this poem of mine, Five Elements, I have compared a woman to these five elements. So the poem goes on. Thank you. She's thy manifestation of existence. She's the nurturer, the mark of persistence. To a new life, she is capable of giving birth, portrays, she's derived out of element of earth. First element. Second one, from a cool glacier to a rain-bearing cloud, she dons the various roles with flair and proud. She's a mother, a wife, and a daughter. Depicts, she's made up of element of water. Coming to the third one. She's the source inhaled to live. Thy energy for existence she would give. Prevailing around as a hymn and a prayer illustrates she contains the element of air. Tranquility and vibrations all abound. She's thy medium of all the sound. her spirit and soul soars high, represents she has an element of sky. She could generate the heat to perish all with her strong grit in wake of a gall. She is apt to escape any intricate mire, signifies she is built with the element of fire, signifies she is built with the element of fire. Thank you.
Wow, what a poem, Shweta. Beautiful, really enjoyed beautiful. Listening to your poem.
Powerful.
And Purnima, yeah. How much time do we have, Purnima, after this?
What's the time right now? What's the time?
9:55.
Okay, so I think we should be able to wind up the session in 10 minutes because the poems are short and sweet.
Yeah.
Yes. And, you know, so the viewers are not getting bored. So
yeah, that's very important.
They are so involved.
Yeah. Oh, Purnima, it is your turn. So I invite you to please render your second poem.
Thank you so much, Simaji. Thanks a lot. So I mostly write nature poems and spiritual poems. So, you know, poets have written about flowers. They've written about birds. It was Wordsworth, who said, "A voice so thrilling never was heard in springtime from the cuckoo bird. No nightingale did ever chant more welcome notes to the weary band of travelers." Well, poets have written on nature. They've written about flowers and birds. I have written this poem about a corpse flower. This particular flower is hated by everyone because it has a stench. And it's called Rafflesia arnoldi. When I was in Indonesia, I had the privilege of viewing this flower, which is supposed to be the largest flower in the world. Largest flower in the world, Rafflesia arnoldi. And we have two biologists here. I really wonder if you take interest in botany. But, this particular poem combines nature.
You've been teaching this a lot.
So I'll read Rafflesia. "The biggest tale that a floriculturist would ever tell would revolve around the gigantic flower found in Indonesia. Hang on to your hats, dear readers. This one's about Rafflesia. To the island of Sumatra, the naturalists had sailed in search of natural treasure, the greatest prodigy of the botanical world, has value that's hard to measure. Rafflesia, the queen of parasites, has enormous flowers, as if she's the eighth wonder of the world. It is gigantic, people. It is gigantic. It is huge. As if she's the eighth wonder of the world. A full 3 feet in size. Rafflesia arnoldi. The name rarely heard. She's a gargantuan flower power. 15 pounds the flower weighs. She's quite a sensation. Who's been breaking records all the way? Have you ever, heard of flowers breaking records? But here Rafflesia is doing that. And then coming to her aroma, most certainly not like a rose. But whether she smells good or stinks, if at all, depends on your olfactory organ, the nose. Rafflesia is a great topic for research. Intriguing to trace the secret behind these plants. The humongous size is bewildering. Even flowers can resemble elephants. Her habitat is shrinking, dear friends. Well, my poems mostly have a moral in the end. So I'm just trying to convey that, though this flower has a stench, this flower power has to be preserved. And we need to take care of Mother Nature, whether it's an insect or a flower with a stench. We need to appreciate, we need to learn to stand and stare and be in proximity with nature, be in communion with nature for a little while. Yeah. Because as Jagdish Chandra Bose rightly said, even plants have life. Plants do understand and they do receive the vibrations that we give them. Her habitat is shrinking, dear friends. Mother Nature made her painstakingly. Take care of these species. Rafflesia isn't as common as rose and lily. Her heaven is unusually dark and moist on the lofty Mount Kinabalu. This is where this flower is found. You will only see two or three in number. This sanctuary is a first step for her preservation is overdue. So, you know, we talk about animals, tigers, you know, all these species are getting extinct gradually.
Endangered.
But some flower powers are also getting extinct, and we need to, it's high time that we pay attention and think about it. Thank you so much, dear viewers, and thank you so much, dear friends.
Very nice, Purnima, and the message at the end is very important. Yes,
very nice.
The endangered species must be protected, and we must all make efforts for that, in that direction. Okay, so moving on, I think we will take the viewers' comments in the end now.
After
my poem. So here I would now like to present my next poem. And after listening to the various poems from all the fellow poets on different themes, my poem is going to add an altogether different hue now. It's written about a small child and the innocence of a small child. So I wrote this poem looking at my grandchild, the way she was hopping around gleefully in a joyous mood. So that was very captivating, and I penned this like that. So
she has a grandchild. She has a grandchild, dear viewers.
Yes, I do. Yeah.
Hard to believe.
Hard to believe.
No. Yeah, that's the reality. So the title of my poem is The Hopping Angel. Right. Here it is. Frail of frame and small in size, the tiny little angel with a milky smile, four tiny teeth eager to peek out, as the angel time and again did pout, ecstatically, awfully joyous, squeaking in glee, the miniature angel went on a hopping spree. The zeal, the sparkle, the spring-like bounce, its each step, its delight did pronounce, oblivious of worries, insulated from all cares, the angel was so blessed with its divine share. The entire universe, purged with its pure innocence, created a paradise in its noblest essence. Oh, if only the beatitude of this hopping angel could somehow be beyond change and be eternal. So that was my poem. The Hopping Angel.
How sweet!
Adorable.
I think after the serious poems on Afghanistan and some other poems, I think this was of a totally different
ray
type.
Ray of sunshine after heavy
ray
rain.
Of sunshine. Yeah. Yes, that's right. So Purnima, now I would like you to take some comments before I wind up.
Sure thing. Let me see what viewers have to say. Okay, Pragya says, Purnima Trivedi Kulkarni, my friend, lovely poem. Love you, Pragya. Sunil Tiwari, so beautiful, Purnima ji. Prabhakar Awasthi says, drifting flowers cry sometimes. Smile when it makes smiling buds to drift again. Oh my God, Prabhakar, you're quite a poet, and you know, I'm deeply touched by your comment. Rajkamal Day, Pooja ma'am, say something. Pooja ma'am, say something. Pooja ji, kuch bolie. So relatable, Seema ji. Cute poem. Hey, Pragya, you are not a grandmother, but still, you know, she finds this relatable. Prabhakar says, great, angel shines. Prabhakar is in love, is in head over heels in love with the line, you know, angel shines. Dolly says, beautiful Seema ji. Juma says, that was the perfect way to end the show, happiness. So I think, you know, people like happy endings. They don't want, they want things to end on a note of reconciliation. So that all's well that ends well, says Shakespeare. Beautiful. I think we have Purnimaji waiting in the waiting room.
Yeah, so
I'm just going to take her again. She's just in and out of.
So, dear friend, dear poet friends, it has been a wonderful evening. And what a lovely poetic, what lovely poetic renditions we have had today. And lovely comments from the viewers. I'm sure the viewers also enjoyed the whole show. And it was a fantastic experience to listen to the beautiful poems of all of you. And now I would like to wind up. In the end, I would thank Neelam ji, Neelam Saxena ji, for creating this wonderful and beautiful platform, bringing us all together and giving us such moments of ecstasy. And I would also like to thank Purnima, our admin, Prasoon ji, who helps us with all the poster
he makes the posters for us.
And he's such a sweet person. You disturb him any time of the day and he is, you know, ready to accommodate and to adjust.
He enjoys being disturbed. That's the thing. He enjoys being disturbed.
Thanks, Purnima, for telling this to me. Next time I will feel less guilty. And so thank you, Purnima Rao ji, thank you, Shanti Bhushan ji, and Pooja and Shweta, and above all our dear viewers
wonderful
for joining us and for staying with us and appreciating the poems. So thank you everyone, and it's time to say goodbye, though I don't
thank
feel
you
like
all.
Saying
thank
goodbye
you all.
But thank bye you. For now we'll catch up with you.
Thank you all. Thank you to all the viewers.
Thank you.
And
thank
I would like to thank our moderator.
Thank you, Simaji.
Thank you, Simaji, and thank you, Purnimaji.
Thank you
for moderating the session.
Thank you.
Beautiful poem. I really love the company. And really beautiful poem by everyone. Thank you, Simaji, for wonderful moderation, and Purnimaji for being a wonderful admin with all the vanity.
I
love that. How sweet. You know, each time, you know, I read comments, you know, I wear my spectacles.
Purnima Rao ji, for the depth and the grace which you bring with your experience. And Pooja,
thank you so much.
Pooja Nagya, you have a lot of fan to answer to. Please continue that. And please carry on.
Yes.
This happy note, thank
please
you
do
again.
Reply. Do reply to your fan. All right. Okay. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you to all my fellow poets, Neelam ji, and all the viewers.
Thank you so much for
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Good night.
Bye-bye.
Yes.
Bye-bye.